Once upon a time, many moons ago, there was a beautiful intoner and an elderly man. The intoner's only love in life was making dolls. She loved it so, 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 so very much. It was an odd obsession, to be sure. One the elderly man would often worry about if the mood struck him. Looks like your surface is getting a bit rough.
You certainly have a way of losing yourself in your dolls, my lady. Such a pity. I can have any woman I desire thanks to my mighty member. And yet you are the only one who can push me over the white cliffs of joy. In this thick and turgid world, you, Lady Three, stand boldly above them all. Just once. Just once. I wish my lady would open her pleasure barn to me while her dolls were watching. With my body, soul, and technique, I know I would satisfy her as no man ever could. You simply cannot compare some splintered puppet to the majesty of old Octa.
I'll be sure to polish you boys up later. Oh, my charming little dolls.
Good heavens! What are we going to do with you, Lady Three? I stopped keeping tabs on you for just 1 minute, and now you've gone and scared up this horde of little monsters.
These are my soldiers. Octa, you're all shriveled up for a change. Can I slice it off and dissect it?
I prefer you didn't, my lady.
When it's small like that instead of its usual size, it's a lot softer and easier to slice off.
If I might change the subject. May I ask who we'll be rumbling with this time around? Yeah, in battle, that is, not the other kind of rumbling.
My soldiers, the troops I made for one, they've been very bad.
Ho-ho! So you're planning to go forth and dispatch the very monsters you conjured up? A wise and magnanimous gesture, my lady.
If my sister wills it.
Idea you are also meddling with ogres, my lady. It's a sight that would take anyone's breath away.
Demons don't take kindly to people, but a few little tweaks, and I can mess with them all I want.
I don't see how an ogre can bring much enjoyment, no matter how tweaked.
Yeah.
Whatever could round one possibly be referring to?
Octa.
Yes, my lady?
Don't be such a worry, would you?
Ah, yes. A thousand pardons, my lady. These monsters would defy their master and creator. You might say we've got some control issues here, Lady Three.
Yes, they're defective. I kind of forgot I left them in the Cathedral City.
Oh, how distressful!
We must dispose of them. All of them. Sadly, like a picked flower. Cruelly, like a test specimen. Hugo, Alfonso, Carlo, Elmo, and Oscar.
My lady?
Those are their names. I wanted to make a group of brothers, but it didn't quite work out. Their brains' motor signals weren't able to communicate with their nervous systems. I think excess noise in the neural connections ended up slowing their movements. See, my goal was to make good, useful soldiers. To make powerful, beautiful, obedient soldiers. But I failed.
My, you certainly become quite verbose when discussing your soldiers, Lady Three.
Gugglefeet. That one is named Gugglefeet.
Quite a bit faster than those fellows before, I'd say.
Yes, Gugglefeet is gifted. I made sure to learn from my mistakes with the Hugo brothers. I used metal in the neural transmitters to achieve greater accuracy and boost transmission speeds by approximately 45%. Making the metal thin enough was a bit of a challenge, not to mention implanting it into an ovary. But I believe the results justified all my hard work.
You really do love speaking upon the subject of dolls, Lady Three. Oh my! Now it's a pair of nimble soldiers.
That's Keijo and Lachna. They were a gifted pair of children. But something ended up being very wrong with them.
How's that, my lady?
Well, I adjusted the connection between their brains and the optic nerves in their eyes. But in the end, that wound up harming the link between visualization and memory. As a result, they perceived all objects they saw as fluttering red capes. They essentially evolved to a point where they started attacking friends and foes alike.
Fluttering capes? I'm afraid I don't quite follow your illusion. But that aside, I'm not sure I'd classify attacking one's allies as evolving.
You have a point.
Thank you. to the mentor arena. Just the children I wanted to meet. See? Look at them. Look at them. Their nimble movements. Their lithe and well-defined bodies. The way they make decisions based on experience and knowledge. It's fantastic. They were a wonderful perfect success. Like finding pearls in the forest. Are my soldiers not the very best of the best?
Yes, my lady. Yes, of course. But do try to calm down, if you would. There is one thing I am curious about, my lady.
What is it?
The names of these beasts. What do they mean?
They're Spanish for excrement and urine.
Huh?
They're Spanish for excrement and urine.
Oh, well. All right, then. We'll be dealing with imps next, my lady. I must say, these battles are quite exhausting. I haven't been this flaccid in ages.
Can I cut it off?
No, it's fine. I'll be back at attention in no time. Now come, we have imps to dispatch.
Thank you.
Where's that strange message again?
Imps can fly, you know, way up high, high in the sky. Sky high. I thought my forces needed an aerial component, you see. But calculating turbulence and drag and all that is tricky. I went through a lot of failures. It's hard to do sky high.
Well, I can certainly see why, my lady. Mathematics are not my strong suit either. Of course, I don't have any strong suits outside of headquarters.
I built these children because I wanted tiny soldiers. I call them my little rondos. An experiment in miniaturization, you could say.
And how did this experiment turn out?
Well, they move quickly, but their durability is lacking. Very cute, but very weak. Cuteness is the best thing a doll can have, but weakness is the worst thing a soldier can have, you know? It was a bold experiment, mixing the best of the best with the worst of the worst to open up new horizons in military science.
Ah, right. A failure, then. This must be another brigade of your tiny soldiers.
Yes, but they're a lot less durable than the previous set.
Oh? That's disappointing.
I tried to create lots and lots of them, but well, it's like the camel's hump, you
know. What?
The camel's hump. Big numbers don't create weakness.
I see. Your analogies are as difficult to understand as ever. Lady Three, I hate to bother you right now. But I need to have a discussion with you about our nightly escapades.
You mean
Yes. I fear that dark clouds have gathered over a relationship that once boasted great quality and quantity. Especially quantity.
It can't be helped. I got bored.
Oh, good heavens. Is that truly how you feel about me, my lady? After all the lustful peaks we've scaled, the cargo we've stowed, the culverts we've sluiced.
Yes. I don't hate it. I just don't care if we do it or not.
these children are bigger, like a rainbow over a waterfall. I needed stronger soldiers, so that's why I need them.
They certainly are overwhelming.
Indeed, but they're slow, too slow, a fatal weakness. I can't seem to get size, strength, and speed together in one package.
You can't always have everything, I suppose. It's often difficult to find length, girth, and endurance in one package as well.
Making soldiers is difficult. That's probably why I keep on trying.
I must say, my lady, all these monsters are beginning to exhaust me.
Oh, I like them. Or I like making them, anyway.